Hey, can you take a look at this? I've been staring at this battery icon for the last 9 hours and I cannot figure out why I hate it so much. But I actually think I had an epiphany recently, so with you today, I kind of want to break down the new design of macOS 11 Big Sur, and I want to look at the things that could use some improvement. So if you're ready, let's dive in. Hey guys, how are you all doing? Really? That's just great. You know, I'm doing pretty great today too. So macOS 11 Big Sur is a huge release from Apple. It's not just a design update, but it's also paving the way for future Macs that are based on Apple Silicon. So there's a lot of big stuff here. But as with any new design, there's gonna be some issues. It's just a beta right now, but I kinda wanna look at it and break it down and be nitpicky. Because I think there's some parts of it that are a little bit ugly. But hey, what do I know about looks, right? Well, I do know a little bit about design though, so we're gonna take a look at that. And I'm gonna start with the good stuff, just so I don't sound like a total dick. Let's take a look. So for starters, I do like that new abstract wallpaper. I think it looks nice, and I think the Big Sur photo wallpaper also looks really good. But if you've seen the show before, you probably know that I like to put my own photography as the wallpaper, so I decided to do that. The notification center looks pretty nice. It combines the widgets and the notifications into one view instead of having them separate like macOS Catalina. And the editor also looks pretty nice. This part I think looks clean. Also, the new sheets are pretty nice. So instead of sliding out of the top of the toolbar like they have been since 2001, they now kind of just pop up in the middle of the screen and they're still attached to the window just like the previous sheets. They just look a little bit different, a little fresher. I also like that an app can have a dominant accent color assigned. Just like in iOS, a developer can make an app and assign an accent color. Pretty sweet, but if you want, you can override that color with a color you choose in the system preferences. So those are some of the things I like. Good, we got the good stuff out of the way. Now the part that everybody loves, the complaining. Just kidding, we're gonna be somewhat constructive. Or are we? The first thing that stuck out to me is the icons. So Apple is definitely going for that rounded square look just like they do with iOS, and I'm kind of okay with that. And I don't think it's that bad. There's some icons that I think look really good. I think the Automator icon looks great. I think the text edit icon looks great. But there's some icons that they feel off. I'm looking at you messages, particularly messages, FaceTime, the App Store, stuff like that. Apple for a long time has had this flatter look, and I think it's fair to say Microsoft pushed that a lot with their Windows style. Everything got really flat. So Apple started doing this flat thing, right? But they used to do this skeuomorphic look, more three-dimensional look, and I think that looked good. I think the flat stuff looked good. It looks like they're trying to combine that stuff now, but for some of these graphical elements, they kind of sit in the uncanny valley. There's this awkward spot between skeuomorphic 3D and flat, where some of these designs are sitting and they just don't feel right. Now I know everyone's gonna have a different opinion, but I've already seen quite a few people complain about these icons and I am in the same boat. I think the main things that stick out are the shadings with the gradients and the excessive drop shadow. So the way I see it is a lot of these icons have a flatter look, but they have a little more depth to them in some areas. But then there's some of these icons that just seem to stick out way further because they have this more rounded 3D extrusion kind of look, and this bigger drop shadow makes it look like the objects are floating above a surface more. I think that's what kind of throws me for a loop, and it looks a little weird in my opinion. Something else I noticed that's similar is with the Finder icon. Yeah, I can see they're trying to go for a more three-dimensional head look with that like three-quarter view of the head rotation, but it's in such a flat style. At first glance, it just looks like the face is off center. Eh? So it seems like there's a mixed bag of design languages here in terms of the iconography. And in the system preferences, that's another great example. Some of the icons I think look really great, but then there's one in particular that really sticks out. It's this bell. It just has so much roundness trying to stick out at you, and it has like this metal reflective look where it looks almost too real, and in my opinion, it just kind of sticks out and doesn't fit in very well. So now we get back to that battery icon. The icon in the system preferences actually looks okay, but when you actually open up the battery health pane, that's where you see the abomination. So what's wrong with it? Well, if you like it, you like it, whatever. But it seems like it can't decide what it wants to be. In the older days, Apple had battery icons that were very clearly cylindrical. Recently, they went flat. You can tell it's a basic rounded rectangle flat shape. Pretty simple. This, though, I don't even know. It's like it's flat, and then it has a lump, and then it goes flat again. It's like there's mixed perspectives of, like, topology in this battery graphic, and it just feels weird to look at. Again, with the tip of the battery there, it looks like it would be a rounded 3D object, but then it, like, blends into a flat shape again, so it's like you're round and then flat and then round and flat, and, like, it's just a weird mix. Again, it's that uncanny valley of this very interesting design language. All right, enough about icons. Let's talk about the menu bar now. So the menu bar has pull-down menus that are now separate from the menu bar itself. Normally they're attached, but now they kind of float below the menu bar. And as you'll notice, a lot of stuff is round now. Pretty much everything has rounded corners now. In my opinion, the rounded corners being everywhere is a little too much for me. I think the moderation that was in the last system was okay, but now it's like they want to round every freaking corner. Again, there's some subjectivity there, but let's look at some objective things here. Alignment. All right, so this menu looks good. 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 And I'm gonna stop you right there. See, this menu does not line up properly with the highlight in the menu bar. That is a little weird. So I'm sure Apple will fix that, no worries, but those kind of things, attention to detail wasn't really acknowledged there, but again, it's a beta.
And there's also no consistency.
Another thing is the highlights in the menu when you mouse over an item also have rounded corners, but for some reason, not everywhere. In right-click contextual menus, the rounded corners are there. In the menu bar menus, the rounded corners are there. In the knock menus, suddenly the rounded corners are gone. So that needs a little fixing. By the way, I do like the new drive icons. Another thing I noticed, particularly with the help menu, is sometimes the highlighted item will just smash right against the top of the menu, so you have two different shapes directly touching each other on that tangent, which just, again, looks weird. It's like two things are touching that are not supposed to be touching, so a little bit of spacing there could be really nice. Control Center is now in macOS. I think it looks okay, no big complaints here, but the one thing is I've noticed when you go to navigate to a submenu inside the Control Center, there's not a real obvious way to go back a page. You have to click the title of the setting you're changing, like keyboard brightness, and then it brings you back to the main menu. I think a little back arrow or something would be super handy there for people who don't know where to click. All right, let's talk about toolbars and windows. So in Big Sur, one thing you'll see is top to bottom sidebars that consume the whole side of the window. I think this is a little bit of a space waster, but I guess it's okay because now you have a more dedicated spot to click and drag your window right next to the window buttons, I guess. But the toolbars look, I don't know, this might just be me needing to get used to it, but the toolbars just look really thick now, almost too thick. I guess that's just a personal preference, but another thing I'm not a huge fan of is these, like, button shapes going on. I know they're replicating some of the iOS stuff, but it just looks weird that the buttons are so close to each other, and, like, when you click on one, the spacing becomes even more minimized, and it's like those tangents are touching. I don't know if I'm using that word right, but, you know, those lines are touching where it looks like they shouldn't be touching. So again, a little more spacing there would help a lot in my opinion. I've also noticed that those tabs in toolbars are inconsistent between certain apps. I'm not sure if this is done on purpose, but you can see the design language of the tabbed bar in the Photos toolbar looks and behaves different than the tab bar in, say, the Activity Monitor. Not sure why, maybe they're just testing what works better and they'll 86 the other one and bring in the one that works. I also noticed that certain window controls in some windows, like the close button and everything, are kind of too close to the edge. It looks like they're about to fall off, so hopefully that gets fixed a little bit too. So speaking of things getting fixed, I'm all for people bringing problems to the table, but if you're gonna bring a problem to the table, bring a solution. And the solution is the feedback assistant. Seriously, guys, whether you're a developer, I mean, you probably know this if you're a developer, but you know, if you're a developer or if you wanna test the public beta, use the feedback assistant, submit your suggestions to Apple, because they will change stuff. When macOS 10 Lion came out and it had that new user interface, the design was getting tweaked, I think, with every single developer preview. So Apple will make changes to this. They will refine it. I trust them. But again, Whether you're a developer or just a public beta tester, use the feedback assistant and submit suggestions. Speaking of feedback, I do want to know what you think about macOS Big Sur, because there's a lot of big changes going on here, so I want to know your thoughts. And if there's any other ugly things you want to point out, do let me know in the comments down below. Also, if you want to get any other cool things from myself and the Computer Clan, we have some bonus goodies available to members of the channel, so you can go ahead and click the join button down below or with the link in the description. And when you do so, you will also be supporting the channel, so thank you very much. If you like this video, you know what to do. Thanks for sticking with me. Catch the crazy and pass it on.